I went to the best garage sale that I have ever been to in my entire life and fell in love with a bunch of sofas and settees that all needed to be reupholstered. Like this swoopy little Victorian moment, this entire row, frankly. But would you get a look at this hot little number? Eastlake Parlor Settee for $50. Obviously, she needs some work. She needs to be reupholstered, but fabric can get really expensive, so found this absolutely stunning faux fur blanket on Amazon, and my very first thought was that would make the bougiest couch ever. I chose the teal, but it comes in many, many other colors. Don't worry, I got you. The link is in the description box below. Of course, you can use any color that you want. White's the big one right now. Personally, I salivate over these dark and moody Victorian interior vibes, but I don't have the BA double hockey sticks to paint my walls that color. So it's going on my furniture instead.
It is just the most beautiful sheen.
Can you tell I'm completely obsessed? The backside of this fur blanket is a velvety material, and I'm going to be using both sides. I'm concerned the fur won't hold up very well if the actual seat part gets a lot of use. These are fingernail scissors I'm using. They worked perfectly to cut just the threads without ruining the fabric. FYI, it took about 45 minutes to get all of these tiny threads cut and this blanket pulled apart. The upholstery is currently a ripped, filthy, disgusting mess, but luckily it's not the original upholstery. So I'm gonna turn this shabby little hot mess into a piece of furniture that I can be proud of. I have never technically done a reupholstery project this size before, but I did prepare myself by watching tons of videos on YouTube, and it looks really easy. I'm sure it's gonna be a piece of cake. It was definitely not a piece of cake. Not only that, but something went horribly wrong during the filming process. So apparently, I never turned on the B-roll camera and missed the entire process of me reupholstering this couch. Either that, or there's an automatic turnoff for cussing, because let me tell you, there was an awful lot of cussing. But I hung in there, and eventually I did get it done, and I am so glad that I did because, wow, she is stunning. Of course, if you're just starting out, I would highly recommend you start with something very small, like a stool.
This was a big project. It was a lot. But you know, if you are trying to like work on control issues, this would probably be the perfect size project for you to start with. You know, you might want to call your therapist first, and that's not going to be enough. You're going to need more support than that, so make sure bestie is on the phone, like on speaker with you the whole time. Get, you know, like a jug of your favorite thing to drink. But all in all, I do think it was worth it. I am really happy with this. I could not be happier. I think it's just the super bougiest couch I've ever had in my whole life.
This red couch is my next project. If you want to see the whole video, you can just click the little gray link at the top and it'll take you straight to the video.
I love it so, so much, but I am so, so glad it's finished. So if you enjoyed watching me torture myself fixing up this project and you'd like to see more of those, please leave me a message in the comment section below and hit subscribe, because that's mainly how I decide what kind of content I'll be providing.
For the fastest and easiest way to see more of my videos, including thrifting, garage sales, flea markets, and more DIYs, you can go to the description box below any of my videos and hit the show more button. Scroll down to find a link to my channel, as well as links to anything I've mentioned in my video, along with a list of my most recent videos.
Thank you so much for joining me, and until next time, happy thrifting!